Let's take a look at how we do the calculations when we are revising depreciation. So when we're revising periodic depreciation, that is okay. Management is allowed to make changes in the assumptions that they originally had when they bought the asset. When we do that, it's accounted for as a change in the future, meaning that we don't go back and recalculate depreciation on the prior years. We're just going to find our new assumptions and move forward. And so the process is, when you change those assumptions, is to first determine the new depreciable cost and then divide that by the remaining useful life. So let's look at an example here. On January 1, 2018, the Morgantown Company ledger shows equipment valued at $32,000 and accumulated depreciation of $9,000. That depreciation resulted from using the straight line method with a useful life of 10 years and a salvage value of $2,000. On that same date, the company concludes that the equipment has a remaining useful life of only 4 years with the same salvage value. So what we need to do here is step one is determine the current book value. So our problem tells us that the equipment original cost was 32, accumulated depreciation is 9,000, and so the book value then is 23,000. Now that we have the book value on the date of the revision, we can recalculate depreciation from now forward using our new assumptions. So we're going to take that remaining book value that we just calculated, subtract out the salvage value to determine the remaining depreciable cost of 21,000. Then we can take that remaining depreciable cost, divide it by the 4 years remaining useful life, and now we know that the new annual depreciation amount is $5,250. That means that from now on, January 1, 2018 and on, for the next 4 years, the depreciation will be the $5,250. Now let's look at another example where it's worded just a little bit differently. A building was acquired on January 1, 2013 at a cost of $813,000. It had accumulated depreciation of $116,100 on January 1, 2019. The depreciation resulted from the straight line method with a useful life of 40 years and a salvage value of $39,000. On January 1, 2019, management decides that the new useful life should be 50 years with a salvage value of $67,700. So now we need to calculate the revised annual depreciation. So again, our first step is to determine the current book value. So the original cost was $813,000. We're going to subtract out the accumulated depreciation, and we determine that our book value is $696,600. That's the book value on January 1, 2019. So now that we have our current book value, we can take that number, subtract out the new salvage value that they gave us of $67,700, and we can determine that the remaining depreciable cost is $629,200. Now we need to take that and divide it by the remaining useful life, but they told us the new total useful life should be 50 years. So we need to determine the remaining amount. So if the total life is 50 years, we can determine that 6 years have already gone by. They bought it on January 1, 2013, and now it's January 1, 2019. So they've already depreciated it for 2013 all the way through the end of 2018. That's 6 years. So the remaining useful life then is 44 years. So we can take our remaining depreciable cost, divide it by the life remaining, and we can determine the new revised annual depreciation is $14,300. Again, that's what they're going to record for depreciation from January 1, 2019 for the next 44 years to depreciate that asset. So again, in summary, when you're revising the depreciation, first you need to determine the current book value of that asset. Then you can calculate the revised depreciation with your new assumptions.